Baptism service, and when you're marching on the street, he tell me about the spirit clap.
No kind of wife, stop me.
He said, young man, not so to clap. Take your time. One. Clap one.
Yeah.
When you get in, one clap time, one, yeah. Two.
That's right.
Some people clapping out of time.
Out of time, yeah.
So I'm a veteran, they're young and I've got a little fella today. But I listen to him. But you have to listen.
Thank you. That's right.
If you want to hear from God, you have to tune in your ears. Isaiah 50 tells me that God have given me the tongue of the Lord and the ear of the Lord, that I may speak a word to him that is weary in due season. Say, morning by morning he waketh me. And I wasn't rebellious.
Amen.
So God is looking for a trade here this evening. Why we go through some of the stuff that we go through? Because we are listening.
Amen. Say it again, man.
Our friends in the Hindu persuasion, they know tonight is their night. And they call it darkness over light. And I used to...
Light over darkness.
Something like that. Yes. Thank you. And you know, when a holiday come around, a festive holiday, if it's Easter, I say Happy Easter. If it's Carnival, I say Happy Carnival. If it's August holidays, I say Happy August holidays. Christmas, Merry Christmas. Happy Eid. You do that lot of stuff, man. You say, see that happy thing? Stop that. So, he said, when I tell you happy Diwali, I've been a part of your business.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know about you, it's been tough for me like
that. True, that's true.
He said, better tell them happy holiday or have a good holiday.
True.
When I declare that I'm happy for you in your ignorance. No, we get respect. You have to get respect.
Yes, yes.
There's something in spirituality called religious tolerance.
Mm-hmm.
So you learn to tolerate other people religion.
Yeah.
But here's something. These folks, they're a period of fasting. Yeah? I'm going somewhere. This is good. They're a period of consecration. Setting aside themselves, they wouldn't eat meat, they wouldn't drink strong drink, and so on and so on. Because tonight is a big night for them.
Yeah.
What do we do when we who have the knowledge as well as Christians,
right?
What do we do?
Christians.
We can learn something.
Yeah.
The Bible says you can learn something from a dummy. You can learn something. Because you know Paul said at one time, you know, he was passing through Athens and Mars Hill, and he said, when I pass by, I behold your devotion.
Yeah.
And I see your inscription, Mars to the unknown God.
Yeah.
He said, oh, whom you ignorantly worship. He said, this God that you're talking about is my God, Jehovah God, but you call him the unknown God. You're worshiping, but you don't know. Psalm 115 says, not unto us, O Lord. He said, I need to talk about your name, give praise. And then he says that some folks, they're worshiping them.
Idols, yeah.
They have, they think they have
mouth.
They think they have eye. They can't see. They have head.
No,
they can hear your prayer.
No, they can't
see. They are not, but they can't sense you.
Yeah.
Their mouth.
And feet.
Oh Lord, their hands.
They cannot move.
They have feet.
They cannot walk.
But they can't run to your assistance.
Those that make them are like
them. He said,
them
that make them
are like them.
Are likened unto them.
Yeah.
And so is those that worship them.
Yeah.
And you go to the book of Isaiah 44 and Isaiah 40. They tell you a man take a tree, go in the forest. He take a tree that wouldn't rot. He choose out a tree. You know?
Yeah.
We're talking about people who worship him and they understand.
Yeah.
He choose out a tree. You want to make a change. You look for a tree. That is conducive to we want a long lasting change. Cut it down. Carry it to the summit.
Of course, Jesus.
Pass it. Remember something, you know, that rough number and that smooth number? That's something called a. Jack play. Yeah. Pass it to the jack play. Yeah. And then he go to the wood workshop. You know exactly what you have in mind, what you want to make.
But,
you want to make something with 10 head and 6 foot, 10 hands. So he go to the carving man. and the man carve out. Then he put some varnish, he sand it up, make it smooth, and he put some varnish on it. And he built a nice yard for it. And he put it on a van. And he's driving around the door. He moved it from room to room in his house. He cannot believe that this God that he made will work for him. So he trying milk and all kind of things. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Yes? Yes. And he worship the God so ignorantly. But he believed that when he prayed to this God, whatever you ask for, you'll get. Friends, today I want a God that could carry me. I don't want to carry no God.
Yeah.
All right. Amen. You don't hear that?
What a weight, man.
I want a God that could carry me.
Yes.
He said, have thou not known? Hast thou not heard? That the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither is he weary. There is no searching of his understanding. He giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increaseth strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall not be forced. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up
wings like eagles.
Yes.
They shall run. Never get weary, and they shall walk on their feet.
Yes.
I thank God to be here today. Yes. Now, Marshall, I really honor your invitation, Deacon Marshall. And I walk with it. That two Thanksgiving to go to, and I have it. Pastor there, going to one ourselves, spend an hour there. But then when I said, look, I get our official invitation. I said, boy, come in the Thanksgiving and stay here. And trust me, I have a great time. I'm having a great time.
Amen.
In the presence of God.
Praise the Lord.
But Marshall, I don't know who write this for you, but it says that life, your granddaughter, she here? God bless your granddaughter. Yes, praise God. Put your hands together for granddaughter. Sometimes you do something you don't know that the Holy Ghost inspire you. Life should be measured not by the number of years, but rather by love.
Yes,
sir. The love shared, the memories made, the joy given, and the blessing received.
Amen.
Yes. I keep in this.
Amen.
Let a whole message to preach. I have time to preach that. And it's a plenty more preachers. But I thank God for you. You can answer. In your prayer, you mentioned about your wife, where she's home with your sister.
Yeah.
She's there?
Yeah.
Please put your hands together for wife. Yeah. But I said, man, how people to say that, oh God? While the man praying, the woman walking in dancing. Only the fool will say
he
has. I thank God. I thank God. I thank God. God is the greatest. Yeah, he's a problem solver. He's a doctor in the sick room.
Yes.
He's a lawyer in the courtroom.
Amen.
Isaiah says he's a wonderful counselor. The Almighty God.
Everlasting Father.
Lord have mercy. The everlasting Father. And the Prince of Peace. As I'm going today, I just want to talk to you. Good. What I like about the German, he never tell me 5 minutes or 10 minutes. That he for. If I preach and if there are no more preachers, that he. But praise God. Praise God. I have discretion. I'm a man of discretion. But I also like the Spirit of God. When the Spirit of God is in operation, listen, you preach with the preachers.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
You don't understand, you're watching me simple. I preach in about 28 years now.
Yeah.
I don't look so. And sometimes I feel like an old man in the preaching.
Yeah.
But you know what I thank God for? that the Spirit of God is alive.
Thank you.
Now listen, you can read the same chapter every time and every time and get a different message to preach.
Yeah, yes, yes.
Spirit of God.
Yeah.
I'm going to creation, Pastor Mark. God bless you. I'm going to creation in Genesis. In the beginning.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
God created the heaven and the earth.
And he said the earth was without form and void. And darkness was upon the face of the deep. That is your life, friends, without Christ.
Yes.
You don't know Jesus.
Yeah.
Your life without Christ is characterized as chaos and confusion.
Yeah.
In the beginning.
Yeah.
You are living. You're just existing.
Yeah.
Everybody could say I'm a child of God. Yes, you are a child of God by creation, but not by adoption. Lord have mercy.
Yes.
By
yes.
creation, all are we go God
yes,
children.
Yes, yes.
All of us is God children. But when you become a
yeah.
These scales are going to fall in.
Lord Jesus.
These scales are going to fall off your eye. Paul said, you know, I come from good stock. Some of you, you can marshal grandchildren and children and so on. You would have taught you how to pray.
Yeah.
In Sunday school and so on. But you want to follow friends and all kind of thing, and you want to. Nothing wrong in seeking good education and getting money, working and so on. But in doing that, you forget God.
Oh, Jesus, yes. Yes, Lord.
Today is a day for the combat to God.
Yeah. Amen.
Yes, Jesus.
Today is a day.
Yes.
Pray to renew your covenant.
Oh, yeah.
Hear what Paul said. I come from good stuff.
Woo!
That chapter that Pastor Grant told me, that whole book is trouble. The book of Philippians?
Yes.
Real trouble. I could preach every word in every chapter tonight. But I ain't gonna do that. I just touched briefly. Paul was in prison.
Yeah.
When Paul wrote this letter to the church at Philippi, Paul was in prison. Paul was in the lockup. He was in the remand prison.
Oh yeah.
In Golden Grove.
Hmm.
You understand what I say? And the conditions in prison is not like the condition now. After I go out and you know, you hear him for a couple of months. You don't know he lock up. When he come back, he look nice and long and fat. And tell you he went to New York. Yes, New York in the prison. In the prison when Paul and them was locked up. First they getting a good looking.
That's right.
Hmm.
And they're getting no medication.
No,
mercy, right. Lord.
They trust them in an inner prison.
Hmm.
And they chain a soldier.
Yeah.
To them. One time, he said, I was the stadium of life itself.
Yeah.
He said, because I look at a man died himself, and they strap on. This fella do so much of wickedness that they put a dead body on this fella.
Lord have mercy.
And the body decomposing.
Oh Jesus.
And they strap on this body.
Paul said in a spirit, man, the tips are between. Having a desire to leave this world. Which is more profitable for me.
Yeah.
But for you it is safe.
Oh yeah.
I am not ashamed. Of the gospel of Jesus Christ. God is the power.
Oh yes.
It's the power of God unto salvation. Hey, you know what it is to preach this gospel? God bless me to write a little booklet. And in the booklet, one of the chapters said that to preach is part of a dynamic event where the living God unveils himself to man. Shows us the incarnation, that is the birth of Jesus
Christ. Yes.
You could begin to imagine what takes place with Mary, a little virgin teenager.
Oh, Jesus.
The Immaculate Conception.
Yeah.
Huh? In those days, she would have been stoned to death.
Truly.
But I hear God talking to Joseph.
Yeah.
That's how Joseph had to play some part in some Mary's life.
Yeah.
Feel like Joseph.
Woo.
To take unto thee Mary to be thy wife. But that which is conceiving her is of the Holy Ghost.
Good.
You interfere with God's business.
Oh, Jesus.
Hey, interfere with God's people.
Yeah.
God have mercy.
Mercy.
Hallelujah.
And see Joseph, God bring forth a son.
Yeah.
And you, Joseph, are what you call him by name. Call his name. Joseph, where you christen this boy?
Yeah.
And I tell you the name. Call his name. Jesus. Why do you call his name Jesus, Joseph? Because Jesus means Savior. He will save his people.
Thank you, Jesus.
Paul started to persecute God people when he was Saul. He didn't understand because after Jesus came, his whole life, and he died on the cross and stuff. Romans' idea of punishment was very barbaric. When they want to silence you, they give you the worst, listen. The among that thing they will do you before you die, you're wishing the dead already.
Yeah.
I said, let's stretch Jesus.
Lord have mercy.
They tie him to a stake and they beat him.
Oh, Jesus.
They pluck the crumbed tongues and they press it down. They didn't recognize like
no.
A tiara.
Yeah.
They press it down on his brow. They drag him to the streets of Jerusalem.
Lord have mercy.
Jesus have mercy.
Oh, Jesus.
They make him carry the cross. He fell down with the cross many times. The word said a 33-year-old man was looking like an old man.
Yeah.
About 32.5 years.
Oh, Lord.
At that age, he was looking like an old man.
Yeah.
Because of the suffering.
That's right.
And the sins of the world that he was carrying.
Yeah.
They strip him of his garment. They gamble. You see the gamble going on now?
Yeah, true. Oh, yes.
They spread him out. They drag the hands in his hand. They tie his feet together. And they drag the hands in his feet. How was it now? They lift up the cross. And then trust it down with God.
Yeah.
And then tear his flesh.
Oh, Jesus.
When he was thirsty, he asked for water. Oh, Lord, have mercy. If somebody asked him for water, and you give them water.
Oh, Jesus. Yes, Lord.
They give him vinegar and God to drink. My Jesus and your Jesus. They find that he was taking too long to die on the cross, so they say, all right, yeah. They will break some legs now. That increases debt. Some old folks, you know, sometimes they hold on, they fall down and they break their limb and then shortly after they die, you know, how a broken limb could cause death.
Yeah.
The shock.
Hmm.
The pain. It sends messages to the heart.
Yeah.
How you can say there is shock and hemorrhaging.
Yeah.
So they say, well, if they break the legs, they will spill up the net.
They were saying he was dead already.
So they came to the first gift.
Yeah.
Bam.
Break it, yeah.
That's not just about the breaking legs. And they're going to break, if they're going to follow the order, they're breaking the legs again.
Yeah.
But Jesus is the star boy.
Yeah, they left him for
this is the trouble, man. So they pass him.
Yeah.
When the devil warns you, they leave you for last.
Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy.
The best for last.
So they went by the next thief.
Yeah.
They broke his leg too.
Lord have mercy.
They came by
Jesus.
Ha! Woo!
Jesus already gone. He's already gone. Hey, that's one of thy bones is broken.
Somebody say you're faking. Don't break your leg. No, don't break your leg. We have something here. I believe they shot me spear that time. I believe they do it like we don't have any other.
And if we think
that they don't
have any
other. Yeah. If I was fun. But he said we're going to hit them back here. If you was still to bend, go hit them. They sharpen the spear, man. And they didn't just...
Ay, ay, ay.
They didn't that's touching with you.
What's that?
If a man die, why you still want to?
So true.
That justice me up in the side.
Like that, man. How the funk him look?
Hey.
Come see me up in.
Remember when he was prison? Because Simeon the priest told his mother that a sword will pierce through and also that the thoughts of many hearts will reveal. Who's up, Zon's gamer? Crystal clear water, that will be baptized.
Tell man.
Water for baptism.
Yes! Blood. Blood touch him.
He's totally touched. Well, coming up. I hear preachers preaching that thing, boy, but you have in heaven, man. They didn't want the blood touch the ground, man. I never preach that. You don't consider any problem, really have a lab in heaven.
I give it to you to know the mystery.
I said, what is kind of nonsense this man preaching? But I am looking in the Bible to see where God didn't touch the ground yet.
You don't know the mystery.
Oh, yes.
Catch it and put the vial and catch up the love in heaven. And when they test the blood, they set up power in the blood. And so the writer, write at him. Boy,
yeah,
so
that right.
There is a fountain.
Yeah, report that one, boy.
Yes, now, hey. When one preacher preached that, people capsizing him.
Yes.
Because listen, when you get cut, in order for the wound to heal, the blood had to clot.
Yes, that's right.
You got blood clot yet?
No. Over 2,000 years ago?
The writer says that is blood.
Never.
It rend the rock that thunder. And it run down in form of stream in the house of David. Yeah. Hey, the sinners.
Oh, yes.
God be the devil rules. There is a fountain.
Rejoice! Oh yeah!
Rejoice! That fountain! And yeah, man!
As vile as he!
Oh yeah!
Too much of us built up.
Oh, did that? Then we caught the grave with.
Yeah. I wasn't there. Church? Only church, because not in a building is church.
No.
Church is people.
That's right.
Worship it. Holy Spirit, yes. And let you. Called out, Ecclesia, they call it. Ecclesia is a called out.
Yeah.
I wasn't there. When they did all this to my Jesus.
Yeah.
But when they came it.
Yeah.
These words.
Oh, yes.
He better with me in mind.
Oh, Jesus.
He better with you in mind.
That's right.
Tell what I was saying. Since my faith,
I saw the stream.
I said I wasn't there.
Yes.
Neither me.
For my faith, I believe
yes.
that Jesus Christ is the Son of the Living God, yes. and by Him our life to His name. Yes.
Oh yeah.
You could say what you want, but my Jesus, but He's mine.
Oh yeah.
He's all mine.
He's mine too.
He's mine, divine. He's all mine. He's mine. He's mine. He's mine.
Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus is mine.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, since by faith.
I saw
the stream.
Oh, the flowing
Lord. Thy flowing womb supply.
Oh, redeem.
Sister Mama, redeem me, love.
Be mighty.
Be mighty.
And shall be
till I die. Sweet as sin. Oh, yeah.
Sing the power to say.
When
a man shall reach 80, and God will bless you if he chooses to live another 80. But when this is spring,
stammering.
I tell that in the grave, you're going to a better land.
Oh Lord.
Oh
Jesus.
Oh Jesus. much of sorrow, yeah, you know.
Yes.
Too much of people hurting your heart and making you cry.
That's right, that's right.
But I'm going to have blessed and we know what is.
Yeah.
My God. Wipe away.
All.
All.
My idea of my God, you have a big handkerchief. Hold that chest. Hold that pressure we see these
days. So true. Yes.
The money that you're working for.
Pressure.
Yeah, pressure.
You can't meet the needs. We have to work.
Yeah.
My God, I'm a big
handkerchief.
One more.
Oh, yeah.
Brother John, yeah. He can wipe away not somebody tears, but I see now what the Lord tears. Roll away the stone.
Yes.
I'm closing.
Yeah.
Matter, roll away the stone.
Yeah.
You only know Jesus as a healer. So you wanted to come quick so that Lazarus would not die. Did you know, church? And if Jesus had really come, Lazarus would not really die.
No, that's
very true.
Why would you know that the I am that I am is also the resurrection and the life?
Life.
So you can know that.
True.
If you tell her no death, I tell me solo of death in victory. So, oh, death, where is your sting? Oh, great, where is your victory? No.
Yeah.
Thanks be to God.
Give us the victory
to Jesus Christ.
Not to the
commandment. Show me where you're
laying. No.
Show me where you're laying.
Oh, Jesus.
Show me where you're laying. That thing was troubling you. You have to show me where it is.
Yes, sir.
Oh, God.
Yes, sir.
That was bothering your trouble. Show me. That white thing coming. Show me. I'm terrible rebellious. Show me them today. Any the boss on the job that pressure on you. Show me, boss. Show me where you're laying today. Show me where you're laying.
Lord,
when Jesus reached, he had just said, I lost some water. You're only the spirit.
Woo!
Ha ha!
Yes.
You understand me.
The meaning.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I like your brother. Nobody else wants to say back. I'm a great
woman.
I'm weeping. Church are weeping. I'm wailing. Sorrow upon sorrow. Man that born of a woman few days. Full of trouble.